The San Diego Prep Insiders Basketball Podcast is powered by Jersey Mike's. Jersey Mike's, a sub above.
Hi, folks. What's Christian up? Pedersen, Aaron Bergen.
Hey, guys.
Steve Jones's Twitter. We're going to try and break down the D4 basketball championship. It's Southwest El Centro. It's San Diego. Mm-hmm. You might not have been able to read that tweet, but we're sitting here a day out, and it's already disproportionately starting to stack up in San Diego's favor. So, Aaron, let's do this. We'll make our first-round case for San Diego because that's, I'm assuming, where we're both picking. But then let's also just not make light of the fact that Southwest El Centro has clawed their way into a final in a very impressive manner. So starting with San Diego, though, I'm assuming that's who you're picking.
Yes. And for obvious reasons, Thomas Marcus is, he's absolutely taken over games throughout the playoffs, but the emergence of Emmanuel Henry as a very potent Batman to Thomas Marcus's Batman. Got to get my comic book characters correct there, you know what I'm saying? But basically, he's been a hell of a sidekick. And over the last three games, he's recorded more dunks than he did in the entire season. Three games, whole season.
Which we'll make sure that both of us retweet that dunk from the game.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. Watch your head, one of those moments. He had one at halftime that was as impressive, if not more. Thomas saves the ball baseline, throws a hammer pass to the other baseline. Emmanuel gets it one dribble and with two hands puts it over 6'5 Dre Benson at the halftime buzzer. Crowd went insane. It was a crazy environment. Kudos to Guajome Park Academy, though. Good sports. I've known a lot of those kids since they were younger when we lived in North County, so it was fun to reconnect with those folks. But San Diego, just way too much weaponry in Division IV. I think they get it done. I don't think it's going to be a blowout. I think it will be competitive in the first half, but I think pulling away late, and I think it's somewhere within the 10 to 15 point range.
We'll bring up why you think it's competitive, because Southwest El Centro, an 8 seed, mm-hmm. has clawed their way all the way into the finals, much similar to how their football team did it, with nobody really giving them the credit or the due, like, oh yeah, we expect them to be here. So just out of that final, what makes you think that it will be competitive?
Well, earlier in the year on Prep Hoops SoCal, when I did the Division IV preview, I said that El Centro, Southwest, and San Diego would be the favorites. Had a chance to watch them down at Christian High School at the MLK shootout against Mission Hills. They were really competitive against Mission Hills. Grant Hansink was a mismatch problem for the first couple minutes for Warren Washington because he was able to stretch him out, hit 15 to 18 foot jump shots, 6'5", really chiseled power forward. Eric Pompa, really good shooter. Ryan Silva, an excellent shooter. And these guys all were on the football team as well that made that deep run. So, they weren't really an 8 seed because they played so much of the beginning of the year without their full complement of guys. Once they got them all back into the fold, they started winning games, started looking like the team that was, going to be the co-favorite. Beating Maranatha on a buzzer beater, going out and gutting out a game against a good Tri-City team in the 4-8 matchup in the semifinal. I mean, they're here for a reason. And, they come in with a chip on their shoulder. Division IV teams from Imperial County have been historically competitive. Brawley last year, came out and just absolutely flattened Olympian. A couple years before that, Brawley took a beating to Mission Vista, but played tough, and they were a team full of juniors. So I'm just suspecting that the tradition of being competitive East Imperial County teams with talented multi-sport athletes will continue.
So is this they have to grind it out, slow every possession down, play to the shot clock as low scoring as possible? That's their route to keep this one in it? Or do they need to turn this into an absolute athletic shootout?
No, I think they need to turn it into a shootout. That's where they're most comfortable. When, the beginning of the Mission Hills game, they came out the first three possessions, they had 8 points, two threes and a two-pointer from Grant Hansing. So they like to get it up and down. They like to move it, which kind of plays into San Diego's favor because that's how they like to play. And if it turns into that game, it'll be very fun for the fans. But ultimately, there's just
The firepower is too aggressive, too much on the San Diego side. I will say this, though. A game like that, if you put it in the finals, even if it does get to be a 10 to 15 point San Diego game, if you have the three quarters track record of, man, they've been banging threes in, you still are entertained until the very end, because you're like, they could put this together up until the very end, even if San Diego has it in control. Mm-hmm. I'm going to agree with you that San Diego is the odds on favorite. I'm already starting to think, out of how low of a division San Diego is in San Diego, how good can they be in the state run? How interestingly seeded can they be? Because this could be a team that would compete even up to maybe the D2 basketball finals here in San Diego. Mm-hmm. Like,
I'd say
D3 definitely, D2 maybe, D1 probably not, open division definitely no.
I would say this is a team that would be a Final Four, the potential Final Four in D3, you know, second round Division 2, and that's kind of
so you just start looking at it going, okay, granted they have one more hurdle, but this is a team that has a little bit of excitement past that CIO.
And they will, you know, San Diego Division 4 teams have slipped into D5 for state.
That's what I'm saying.
And so they could be positioned for a run similar to what Olympian did last year. I mean, Olympian got 2 wins, made it to the third round of the Division 5 state playoffs before bowing out. I mean, you could see something very similar. I mean, there are some really good teams. Don't get me wrong, Southern
State. And we don't need to go into the whole state thing. I'm just saying that's the level of excitement that comes with the San Diego team, is that you can already start smelling that next level of success for them. So for both of us, we are picking San Diego, but we could be wrong. We could be right. Who knows? We'll be there. You'll be there?
Yes.
I'll be there. You'll be there. We'll have a post-game podcast for you. We'll have highlights. We'll have interviews. Even if Southwest Out Central wins, I'm still getting you on for a podcast.
Of course.
Deal. We're both objective.
We can do this. I'm a professional, man.
Exactly. And on that note, we will send a professional send-off. Christian Pedersen, Aaron Berg, and Mr. CPED Full-Time Hoops 1, and we will see you at the finals.